age 15, I left behind my family, friend, and everything I had known in my entire life. I boarded the plane along with feelings of excitement and fear. I was off to start a high school adventure in a brand new country. Before dropping me off at the airport, my father told me, "I don't want you to just carry all my money when I get old. I want you to be able to choose whatever life you want in the future. Getting an education in a different country can widen your horizon. I want you to experience what I didn't have a chance to do." My father's word motivated me to study abroad. That type of love and support gave me the courage to fly across half of the earth at age of 15. He's right. If you have the chance to study abroad, take it. I still remember the first day at Moreau. I was in my honors algebra 2 class with other freshman classmates. Everyone was new to school, feeling nervous and anxious, trying to make new friends. I was talking to three girls around me, answering all kinds of questions about my interests. Then a girl took out her phone. She said, "Add me on Snapchat." Then I was like, "What the heck is Snapchat?" They were just as surprised as you are. Then I got left out of the conversation because I did not have a Snapchat. It's a sad and funny story. It's funny because my answer made people laugh, but it's also sad for me because at that moment, I suddenly lost the connection with local students. I got left out, I was upset. That was my first time experiencing culture shock. As Merriam-Webster defines culture shock as a sense of confusion with feelings of anxious that may expose to people that exposed to an unfamiliar situation without preparation. But culture shock is not as simple as it defines on dictionary. There are a lot going on when a person actually experiencing it. At Princeton University study, broken down culture shock into four distinct stages: honeymoon, frustration, adjustment, and acceptance. The first stage of culture shock, the honeymoon stage, is often overwhelmingly positive during when it is attracted by new sounds, sights, smells, and events. People are excited, curious, having a sense of awe. I experienced my honeymoon stage stepping off my 15-hour plane flight. I immediately saw diversity, people from all ethnic backgrounds, walks of life. I was really fascinated by the similarities and differences between America and my home. The first time I visited downtown San Francisco, I saw various street paintings. Men, women, children, still life portraits. Seems like they could talk to me. Despite my excitement and expectations, I quickly descended into frustration phase. As I navigated through this unfamiliar place, frustration experiences began to accumulate. Simple tasks became major challenges. For example, I could not easily order food at a restaurant if the menu had no pictures. It's really hard for me to understand and pronounce the name of each dish. One time, a waiter asked me, "What kind of side would I like for my steak combo?" I was like, whatever, I don't care. The truth is, I couldn't order because I didn't know what grilled broccoli is. This made me really miss my home, where I have prepared food when I get back. I started to miss my family, especially my grandma. She used to cook really good for me, food for me. There are restaurants in Bay Area, but nothing can compare to a nice dinner at home, especially during holidays, like Chinese New Year. I want some real Chinese food, like braised pork instead of orange chicken. It's hard to order food, but it's harder to make friends. Communication was a huge problem. Despite speaking a different language, American students' conversation always revolved around things I was not familiar with. One time in my biology class, my lab partner said to me, "Hey, you're Gucci." That means he thought I'm cool. But I didn't know, and I was like, I don't have any Gucci on me. So suddenly, I was not a Gucci person anymore. Because of the language barriers, it's hard for international students to make friends. We often feel like outsiders in a local community. According to the Journal of International and Intercultural Institution, it reports that 40% international students had no close friends among their American classmates. Nobody wants to be lonely. It's important to make adjustments. Before, I was afraid to talk because I felt like the conversation will eventually go to a place that I didn't know, then things will get awkward. It's hard to learn a different language. Sometimes I felt like I was not smart enough to be here. But I realized I must adjust to this new culture because America won't change for me. So I started to asking questions and anticipate culture cues. It was not as overwhelming, and I regained my confidence, thus entering the adjustment stage. In this stage, I made more friends, increased my social skills, and learned more about American culture. I find a lot of good Chinese restaurants on Yelp, but sometimes I still want home food. So I learned how to cook in America. My grandma would teach me via FaceTime. I also developed a lot of hobbies, like photography and drawing. I started the school art club my sophomore year and plan to keep studying art as a minor in college. As I develop more hobbies, I have more activities to mingle with American classmates, and I make friends through it. Thus, allow me to get in touch with more American values. I came from a country that has no legalized gay marriage yet, so I learned sexual orientation and gender equality here in America. I attend the Pride Parade in Auckland. I also joined the school LGBT club. I went from just accepting this community to becoming an active ally for LGBTQ+ people. Culture makes people think differently, but I feel the charm of intercultural understanding at my school. I'm communicating with people from all different backgrounds and cultures every day. I'd never have these experiences if I didn't choose to study abroad. But I'm very used to it now. A study from Penn State University states that studying abroad students have a higher level of intercultural understanding skills. Because I understand the benefits of studying abroad, I finally went to the last stage, acceptance. My study abroad experiences has changed and shaped me, become a more open-minded person, which allowed me to do many things I could not have done before. The first time I did my volunteer was in St. Anthony's Dining Hall in San Francisco, where I felt joyful and I found a passion into helping others. So when I was on summer break in China, I wanted to do something for my country. 2017, I became the co-founder of Arc on the Sky organization. We plan and organize summer camps for children from villages that are affected by AIDS. We took them to big cities in China, like Shanghai and Nanjing, so they can get in touch more with big cities and experience the city life. They can see the opportunities the world has to offer. Study abroad makes me a more open-minded person. It motivated me to volunteer in my hometown. And because I have experienced a different life in a different country, I appreciate my country more, and I want to give back to my community. Studying abroad is an adventure. It's so normal, and it's okay not understanding everything. I may not understand every joke my American friends make when we're talking, but it doesn't stop me from being friends with them. I have become transformed to a better person. I'm being more independent. I'm building my leadership skills. I'm immersing myself into helping others. I finally find a sense of belonging here in America. My friends often ask me, how's my life studying abroad? And should they go study abroad as well? I can tell them a couple of facts, that from 2011 to 2016, the number of international students worldwide rose from 4 million to 6 million. Or I can tell them a study from the Journal of Marketing Education on students' intercultural proficiency that studying abroad students have a stronger openness to diversity, which led them to collaborate well in diverse workplaces. Or I can tell them American Institution for Foreign Studies survey that 70% of studying abroad students reports a stronger and a better work salary satisfaction. But study abroad offers so much more than that, and you can gain so much you can imagine. I have become many things I could not have done: independent, dedicated, a leader, and open-minded. To be honest, culture shock and homesickness will be major challenges while studying abroad. But don't be afraid. Studying abroad provides us the opportunity and experiences to meet new peoples from all walks of life and to grow in every way possible. Just like my father told me, I want you to be able to choose whatever life you want in the future. Now I know what he meant. So if you have the chance to study abroad, take it. Thank you.